This is TWIT.
Bandwidth for Know-How is brought to you by CashFly.
This episode of Know-How is brought to you by Automatic, the connected car company that improves your driving and integrates your car into your digital life. For more information, visit automatic.com/TWIT and enter the code TWIT to get 20% off your purchase. And by DigitalOcean. Simple and fast cloud hosting built for developers. Deploy an SSD cloud server in 55 seconds. Try it today for free. Visit DigitalOcean.com, and once you sign up, be sure to enter the promo code KNOWHOW in the billing section for a $10 credit. Today on KNOWHOW, welcome to CES. Welcome to Know-How. It's the show where we build, bend, break, and upgrade. I'm Father Robert Ballester, the digital Jesuit. You may have noticed that we're not back in the studio, and Alex and Cranky Hippo are nowhere near me. That's because we're here in Las Vegas, Nevada for CES. It used to be known as the Consumer Electronics Show. Now it just goes by those three big letters. Now, over the next hour or so, I'm going to take you through some of the booths and some of the tech that I found here in the halls of CES. It's things that might be a good fit for the maker DIY space that we call our know-it-alls. Without further ado, let's take you straight to the tech. Question. You want to make a 3D scan of an area, but unfortunately it's irregular. It's a hole, but it's got dips and curves and bumps. How do you do it? Well, of course, with lasers. I'm here at United Sciences speaking with Carl, a wunderkind who has come up with a solution to look around corners. Carl, how do you do this? You're using this here at EFIT to be able to map people's ear canals so you can make precisely fitting ear products, audio products. But this can also be used to, say, map holes on airplane wings. It's a brand new, unique technology. How does it work?
So it's using laser triangulation. It produces a ring of light at the very tip of the device, and we're using laser triangulation to find the 3D position of that. We couple that with a tracking system that figures out where this is relative to your head if we're scanning your head.
And the tracking system is this right here. So this goes onto the side of a person's head, and it gives it a reference map so that the cameras here on the front of the scanner know where the tip is in relation to this reference point. Now, is that the same system that you use when you're looking at, say, a hole in an aircraft wing?
Yeah, so actually in an aircraft, we are usually on a robot, so we're going to be figuring out where the laser is relative to the aircraft using a robot. We have a handheld system as well that can find the position of itself, but most of the time we're going to be using a robot.
Now, I think we need to impress upon the audience exactly how much of an advancement this is, because we've been able to 3D map objects for a very long time. Sure. But the thing that has always been elusive, and what really messes up 3D body scanners and 3D model scanners, is when you have an irregular curve where light doesn't want to follow. And this is what it solves. Is this the first of its type?
I believe so, yeah. So most 3D scanners actually scan forward, and ours is scanning to the side directly. So if you look at the device, the very tip of it, we're scanning directly to the side of that. So it's the first time that you've been able to actually scan sideways. So that's really good for scanning small holes, so ear canals, undercuts in the ear, or rivet holes on planes.
Oh, of course, here you're showing people how you can make custom earphones, because you want to get the word out. You want to get the name of United Sciences out there so that they could check out the EFIT. But there are so many applications for this technology. Where would you like to see it go next?
So we're bringing it to wearables, hearables. So we're going to have sensors in the ear that can pick up brain waves, pulse. We can do a whole bunch of different things in the ear, and that's where we're going next with this.
Fantastic. Sam, if they wanted to find out more about United Sciences, more about the work that you've done and all your colleagues have done, where can they go online?
They can go to unitedsciences.com.
Thank you very much for speaking with us. Thank you for sharing your tech. And thank you, because we like to see things every once in a while that are truly revolutionary. If you're into 3D scanning, well, United Sciences just taught you how to peek around corners. I'm here at the Intelligent Energy booth at Showstoppers 2016 to show you what the future of power might be. Now, you know that I like myself some quadcopters, but there is one Achilles heel that every enthusiast knows, and that is power. The motors are great. Props are incredibly efficient. We can get very light frames, but you can never quite get enough power into your lithium polymer cells to keep you in the air for more than 10, 20, maybe 30 minutes if you really pack it. Well, that's why Intelligent Energy thinks that the future is this. This is a proton exchange membrane. In other words, a fuel cell. You pass hydrogen through a PEM and you get power. Oh, it's a simple technology, but it's been promised to us for the last couple of years without it really being delivered on a commercial level. And that's because PEMs can be expensive and the technology itself is, well, kind of in its infancy. Intelligent Energy wants to change all that by making this your standard power source. Now look at this. This is a phone that's using Intelligent Energy's design. It uses a carrier. It's a hydrogen carrier. You add water to this and it starts to emit hydrogen. It emits enough hydrogen to keep your phone charged and going for a week. That's right, a week. Replace one of these every single week and it's a harmless chemical and you can have a no charge phone. They've also got this on a MacBook. Believe it or not, this MacBook is being charged by a fuel cell. And they've got this. This is a prototype of a small device. This is actually a proton exchange membrane. This is a fuel cell in and of itself from Intelligent Energy that they believe could become a sort of de facto standard for powering everything from remote controls to your latest RC toy. Now, we are going to see this technology advance. Over the next couple of years, we're going to see more of this packaging and possibly cheaper and cheaper PEMs so the price point comes down. All we can hope is that Intelligent Energy leads the way.
Hi, I'm Michael Bell. I'm with Voxelate. We're a company developing a 3D electronics printer, the materials behind it, and the platform. So as you can see here, we have our Voxelate developer's kit. It's capable of printing two materials simultaneously, a conductive material, and then a matrix material like plastic, epoxies, and silicones. Currently, it's printing an inductor inside of a object, and we're able to embed electronics completely inside of objects. So you can think of antennas inside of cell phones, the electronics printed directly inside of hearing aids, and many other applications. So as the printer is printing, it switches between the two materials. Currently, it's switching to the silver ink. It's going to come in and deposit that silver ink. Now, the silver ink prints and dries at room temperature. There's no annealing, no sintering, no post-processing needed. The black material you see is PLA printed through FFF, which is your standard 3D printing method. So the ideal customer for our product is, you know, those Fortune 500 companies who make electronic devices. So you can think of hearing aid companies where they currently 3D print the shell of the hearing aid, but all the electronics inside of the hearing aid is hand-placed, hand-soldered, hand-finished. With our process, we can do the entire shell to the electronics to the connection of that fully autonomously. Other applications are in cell phones, where there's an increasing number of antennas in those cell phone devices, and those need to be kind of conformal to the shell. And that's very hard to do with traditional manufacturing methods. So with our process, we can embed those antennas directly inside of parts, keeping it away from the user, keeping it, you know, the highest functionality possible. There's other applications that we have in just printing silicone materials with rigid and flexible ones. So you can think of footwear, apparel. You know, I have a Fitbit on. You can think of printing conductors inside of that to get your you know, heart rate, et cetera. So many applications all over the place. So the Voxelate Developer's Kit printer is available, shipping in 2 months for $8,999. It is available in two models. And I'm Michael Bell with Voxelate. And you can find the world's first 3D electronics printer at voxelate.co.
One of the things that we've seen at CES 2016 is the rise of the more intelligent car. Now, it's not enough just to know what's going on under the hood. You now need a car that can gamify. You need a car that can give you the information in a way that makes you a better driver. Now, if you want those features, you could go out and buy yourself a brand new Tesla or a brand new Ford, a brand new GM, or you could just get this, the automatic. Now, the automatic is a simple device that plugs into your controller area network, the ODB2, OBD2 port underneath your car, and allows you to have all those features, but in the car that you currently own. Now, what can you do with the automatic? You can get plain text explanations of the error codes that may pop up on your dash. You can find out what your fuel usage is. You could find out exactly how you're driving, and it can give you detailed responses onto how you make that better. Now, it's not just the car, though, because we know that everything is connected, and the automatic is no different. The automatic can integrate with your current home automation systems, things like the Nest or the Philips Hue. You can use IFTY if you want to set off certain conditions. Like, for example, Leo Laporte has his automatic set up to automatically tweet when he gets within range of the Twit studio. It's sort of a warning to the employees that we better stop messing around and get back to work. Now, folks, I love the automatic. I use it on my Corolla, and I gotta say, the information that it gathers, it's not just informative, it's fun. If you want to truly geek out, if you want to automate your car, if you want to get some smarts from 2016 in your car from wherever, then you need to try the automatic. It's what Twit trusts, it's what you should trust too. Now, right now, automatic is normally $99.95, but because you are a member of the Twit Army, you can save 20% off your purchase by going to automatic.com/twit and entering the code TWIT. Again, that's automatic.com/twit and enter the code TWIT. Automatic for your life. I'm here at the Segway booth, standing next to Jerry White, who just showed me their new Ninebot. This is an amazing advancement in Segway technology, not just because it's cooler, because I can use it in robotic mode, but also because it's 1/5 the cost of an original Segway. But Jerry, our know-how crew, our know-it-alls, actually want to know how it works. I mean, it's fun to ride. We love using these at the studio. What makes this technology stand upright on two wheels?
Let's dispel one rumor. There aren't actual gyros. We always thought it's a gyro. It's much more sophisticated. There's 8 different sensors that get 8 different levels of balance. So these sensors are now operational. You've got 2 independent drive motors, and it's keeping the vehicle upright. It does all the balance. People are mistaken. They think they have to balance. It does all the work. You just let it do the work. As you can see, just forward, slight forward or back pressure with your feet, still balanced, but it allows you to go forward or back. If I push the lean steer, it'll allow me to rotate either direction and turn. Very simple process, very easy and balanced.
What I love about this is people who are excited about accelerometers on their phones or drones, gyrocopters, the ones that use accelerometers to use 4, 6, 8 props to stay in the air, that technology was really pioneered with Segway, because you were the ones who figured out that you don't need a spinning gyro to keep it upright. You don't need 4 wheels. You just need to have a good understanding of force and counterforce.
Yes, and far more sophisticated than my knowledge of it, Dean Kamen, who came up with these ideas. There's even more to it than that. As you move forward, the amount of torque buildup, there's a certain threshold to where the sensors have to know when you have to slow down. So there's so much in play, just as much with a drone. And it's actually more critical, because if you don't do it right, there's only one way off, either the front or the back.
Exactly. Now, I will say this. The first time you step on a Segway or a Ninebot, if you've never been on one before, you're going to be shaky, because your brain's not used to how your body is moving. But our entire crew at Twit, because we did the new screensavers intro on Segways in San Francisco, going up and down hills like Lombard Street, it takes you about 5 minutes, and after 5 minutes, it's second nature.
Yes, that's the beauty of a Segway. Our largest sales globally are the tourism business. There's over 1,800 tours worldwide that people that have never been on one before, moms and kids and dads and grandpas, anybody, 20 minutes of training, and they go out on a tour, a Segway tour, fall in love with it, and they go on everywhere they go, they go on a Segway tour. They're very easy to operate.
Let's do an uncomfortable subject. Not an uncomfortable subject for Segway, but an uncomfortable subject for all the knockoffs. Hoverboards. Hoverboards
are a 4-letter word to Segway.
Obviously, it's a gross violation of your intellectual property, but people know that. The big thing, though, has been safety. They're banned from CES. They're banned from sidewalks. They're banned from most major cities because they tend to blow up. Why is that?
Lithium batteries, which ours use, which most people use because of the power and power to weight ratio and the size, have to be managed correctly. BMS, or battery management systems, have to be in place to avoid overheating and overcharging. We have BMS on the cell level on our batteries. We also have a smart charger that senses temperature, charge level. We charge rapidly to about 90%, and the last hour is all battery equalization. A hoverboard has no smart charger. You plug it in. If you don't unplug it in time, that's where those fires come from. Also, as we know, lithium batteries also heat during discharge. So you have a very small area for the lithium battery, and if the guys that ride it quickly, you're going to discharge rapidly, so you'll see the fires during operation as well.
Believe it or not, this is actually less expensive than the original knockoff hoverboard. This is going to go for $12.99, $9.99, you said, a special on Amazon when it first comes out.
First 2 months, February 1st, for 2 months, it will be $9.99 on Amazon. MSRP is $12.99. One other thing I want to point out, the difference between us and a hoverboard. Hoverboards have a small, like 6-inch diameter hard rubber tire. If you look at this product, you've got an 11.5-inch diameter pneumatic tire vehicle. So it will absorb bumps, and it will have a nice, comfortable, plush ride. So we've built everything into this to make it a true transportation device. You'll notice you have headlights. If you look to the rear, if I turn left or right, I've actually got turn signals. If I back up, I've got brake lights. It's a full functional little vehicle. It's weather resistant. You've got fenders. I can drive in the rain. I can drive through puddles. It's safe in every environment. We did a lot of time and a lot of testing to do it correctly.
Thank you so very much for speaking with us. Now, of course, if they want to find out about this, they can go to the Segway site, they can go to the Ninebot site.
You can go to Segway.com or you go to Ninebot.com. We're a combined company. So this is Segway's, again, our latest innovation. This is the Mini Pro.
There you have it, folks. That's knowledge just for the know-it-alls. Ninebot, it's like a hoverboard, but without, you know, death.
Hi, this is Steve Schell from New Matter, here to update you on what's been happening since the last time you saw us at CES 2015. It's been an exciting year for New Matter. We've got the Mod-T into production, and over the last 3 months, we've fulfilled all the 2,500 orders from our crowdfunding campaign the year before. The Mod-T is a really great entry-level printer for households and classrooms. At only $399, it's one of the most affordable 3D printers on the market today, and it carries a lot of great features at such a low price. It uses non-proprietary PLA filament at 1.75 millimeters, so of course you can buy PLA from us, but you're also welcome to try filament from others. It's Wi-Fi connected, making it very easy to get connected to the online design store and get you up and running fast with your 3D printer. It's also one of the quietest 3D printers on the market. We use a different motor technology than what you find in most 3D printers, eliminating that high-pitched sound that you hear from their motors. This is really important in the household and in the classroom because you don't want to hear that sound running for 5 hours at a time, 6 hours at a time as you're printing the parts. One of the really exciting things that we've announced this week is our Educate and Inspire grant program. We're getting ready to donate over $200,000 worth of product to schools all across the United States. We're accepting applications now at newmatter.com/education. So if you know any teachers that would love to have a 3D printer in their classroom, please send them our way. We're going to select 100 schools, each of which is going to receive 3 Mod-T 3D printers, as well as 15 spools of filament and all the other supplies they need to get up and running. We're really excited about the program. Thanks for helping us share it. Well, thanks for listening. This is Steve Schell from New Matter, and again, newmatter.com to learn more. Thanks.
If I told you that I found the best laptop at CES, you'd probably think it's hyperbole. I mean, that's what all the vendors say. Well, the best laptop isn't an Acer. It's not a Dell. It's not an HP. It's not even from Apple. It's right here at the Razer booth. I'm speaking with Travis, who's going to explain why the Blade is your next Ultrabook. Travis, this is a beautiful piece of kit. Tell me a little bit about this Blade.
Sure, so this is truly the ultimate Ultrabook. It's incredibly thin and lightweight. It weighs only 2.75 pounds and is also 0.52 inches thin. So it's very easy to carry around with you. It has an absolutely stunning, gorgeous display. It's a 4K resolution panel, and it also supports 10-point touch. So you can interact with Windows 10 in all new ways.
Razer's known for gaming, and one of the gaming features here is this keyboard. You weren't happy with just a backlit keyboard. I mean, hey, everyone does a backlit keyboard. You've got individually controllable keys so that you can set it for your particular game.
Exactly. So this is the world's first individually backlit chroma keyboard. Each key supports up to 16.8 million color options, so you can cycle through a number of different effects, or it also has Chroma SDK integration that game developers are taking advantage of, so the keyboard can actually interact with some of the popular new games like Call of Duty.
All right, now there's people out there who are saying, okay, this is nice. I mean, we know that Razer makes decent laptops, and I gotta say the quality on this is nice. From the feel to the touch to the hinge, you've done it right. But here's the thing. If I was to look at this laptop, say at E3, I'd say, oh, that's a $3,000, $4,000 Ultrabook. What's the starting price on this Blade?
Great question. We're really excited about this. It's starting at only $999, and that's with an Intel Core i7 processor.
Okay, folks, just in case you didn't get that, that's an i7 with this screen at $999. Now, it goes up from there. You can add more options, but the fact that you can have that much power in this small of a package for $1,000, that's the starting price for a lot of Ultrabooks with an i5 processor. Well, yeah, that's why this is the best notebook of CES. Now, Travis, I like gaming notebooks because I like to have portable power, but one of the issues that people always have is computers age. We know that. Now, if you have a desktop, you can replace the graphics card, you can upgrade the drive, the memory, but you're kind of stuck with a notebook, which is why Razer came up with another product. Tell me a little bit about that.
Sure. So the notebook itself has Thunderbolt 3. Via that Thunderbolt 3 connection port, you can hook it up to the new Razer Core, which is an external desktop graphics amplifier. Now, the Razer Core allows you to install your own preferred graphics card from either AMD or NVIDIA, and it supports full-size dual-wide GPUs.
That's absolutely incredible. I mean, this is sort of the dream. This is what people have wanted in a notebook for a long, long time, the ability to push out the graphics to something that can be upgraded so that I'm never obsolete. As NVIDIA, as AMD increase the power of their graphics card, I just pop it into this case and I'm good to go. Now, we've got techies on our network, so they're going to want to know the limits to the expansion. How big is the slot? How much power can I pull?
Yeah, so it supports a full-size card. In the example here, we have a GTX 980 Ti. The power supply inside is a 500-watt power supply, so you have plenty of room to power all your GPUs. Now, that Thunderbolt cable will not only transfer data at up to 40 gigs per second, but it also charges the notebook via the single cable.
You heard it here, folks. If you don't have this blade, if you don't have that expansion chassis, I just don't know what you're doing. Travis, thank you very much for speaking with us. If they want to find out more about the blade, more about your expansion chassis, if they want to find out about anything Razer may offer, where can they go?
Razerzone.com or swing by the booth at CES.
That's Razer, and I got to say, for once, I'm speechless. Hey, know-it-alls, I'm here at the Synology booth, the South Hall of CES, because I want to show you something. Now, you're probably thinking, if it's Synology, it's going to be a NAS, right? It's going to be storage. No. Not really. They've released a new product, and it's a router. Now, yes, routers are not normally sexy, but this one has me won over. This is the 1900 AC from Synology, and check this out. So, first of all, the interface looks very much like the interface from the Synology NAS boxes. So, if you know how to use a NAS, you're gonna know how to use a router. This is one of the things I really like. This is a direct translation from their NAS boxes, the package center. This is where all that extra functionality comes in to having a Synology NAS. Well, they've included the same features here. You find the feature that you want, you download it and install it automatically. It's a one-click install. So if you want to turn your router into a media center, if you want to make it a Radius server, if you want it to serve out for a private cloud, you can do that with just one click. That for me, makes this incredible. Now, there are a lot of other features here that non-techies will like parental controls. You can set by device, not just for the router in general, but by the MAC address of a particular device, when and where they can go on the internet. Do you, say, want to block out your kids from accessing the internet when they should be doing their homework? It's as simple as blocking out the time that they shouldn't be able to access the internet. You can also do, and this is super geeky, under traffic control, you get the ability to do beamforming and quality of service per device. So if I want to have one device that always needs the highest level of service because it's doing gaming, I can do that. If I have another device that it's sort of best as can catch, I can do that. Now, we're going to be getting one of these in the studio in the very near future, so I can run it through its paces. But I got to say, if they can make a router as sexy as they make a box of hard drives, I'm sold. Let's take a break from all the CES action to thank the second sponsor of this know-how special, and it's DigitalOcean. Now, if you don't know what DigitalOcean is, you must not have been watching Twit TV, because we're all about DigitalOcean. In fact, we use it. You see, they offer us droplets. These are self-contained sets where we can put pretty much everything we need. Do we want to host an app? Do we want to host a service? Do we want to virtualize a desktop? We can do it all with DigitalOcean. Now, DigitalOcean is used by over 400,000 developers, including me. One of the features that I really love is the fact that I can scale it up and down as necessary. Now, if I just need to test a service to see if it works on the real world, I can open up a service for a couple of hours. But if I want to deploy it around the globe on multiple servers, multiple server farms, well, that's just a flick of a slider and I'm good to go. Not only that, but DigitalOcean makes it easy for you to manage everything with HTML5, an SSH, and a VPN that allows you to get in and do real-time management of all your services and apps. They also guarantee you 99.99% uptime, and their servers are state-of-the-art. They've got up to 20 CPUs, up to 64 gigabytes of memory. Now, not only is it going to be scalable, not only is it going to be the easiest way for you to get your service, your app, your desktop up and running, but you get to deploy what you want to deploy. You choose your OS. Do you want to use Ubuntu, CentOS, Debian, Fedora, CoreOS, or FreeBSD? Do you want to automatically one-click install things like MediaWiki, Docker, Drupal, LAMP, GitLab, and more? Not only that, but their community. The people who actually use the service are incredibly active. That means you get to see real live people who use DigitalOcean for real live problems. Folks, if you're developing, if you're deploying any other way, you're working too hard. I want you to try DigitalOcean and see what it, if it can do for you what it did for TwitTV. Now, right now, because you are a watcher of KnowHow, DigitalOcean has incredibly affordable pricing for you. It starts at just $5 per month. There's also hourly pricing available, starting at less than a penny per hour. But we're going to make it so that it's easy for you to make the choice. You can start now for free. That's right, for nothing. You've got nothing to lose. Just go to DigitalOcean.com and create an account. Once you sign up, enter the code KnowHow in the billing section, and you'll get a $10 credit. That's KnowHow in the billing section, and you'll get a $10 credit. That's plenty for you to get started with and see if DigitalOcean is the right solution for you. Again, that's DigitalOcean.com, and in the billing section, enter the code KNOWHOW. And we thank DigitalOcean for their support of KnowHow. So, you're a quadcopter pilot. You think you've mastered the skills of flight. Well, if so, maybe you need a little disco in your life. I'm here at the Parrot booth speaking with Frederick. Is it Frederick?
Frederick.
Perfect. Who's going to explain why Parrot has gone fixed wing. Why fixed wing? I mean, all the buzz has been about multi-rotor craft, and now you've given us a more traditional flight.
Yeah, so this is the latest drone from Parrot, the Parrot Disco, and we want you to have a new user experience compared to the traditional bebop and the traditional quadcopter. Here, for example, when you fly with this kind of product, you will have a very immersive way to pilot. You can use FPV glasses with the front camera that's in the front of the product, and it's possible to use FPV glasses so you can have the video streaming in front of your eyes. When the wing rolls, you will have the video that rolls also, and you will be in the air, and you will travel in the sky by yourself. It will be a very amazing, good experience.
Now, we can geek out about the specs, the fact that I can do FPV, the fact that there's a 1080p camera in the nose, the fact that I can get 45 minutes of flight, but I have to ask, for the folks out there who know multi-rotor craft, they're probably going to be asking themselves, why would I want a fixed wing? What does a fixed wing give me that I can't get off of my quadcopter?
So, with a quadcopter, you have the feeling that you are suspended in the air. Here, you will slide in the air. You will make some curves in the air, and it will be very amazing. It will be very different. This is a fixed wing drone that is very easy to use also. There are three main parts, two wings, one body. You can just plug the two wings on the body and you are ready to fly. This is very important, it's very easy. So you take the product in the hand, you shake it, the motor starts to spin and you are ready to get the takeoff. So you throw it in the air and it will climb automatically to 50 meters altitude, making some circles in the sky. So now you can use the remote sky controller Wi-Fi product that allows you to pilot very easily the drone. It's not like a plane. You don't have to handle the mixing of the roll and the pitch. Here, if you want to turn on the left, you just pull the or move the stick on the left. There is an autopilot that will automatically manage to keep the same altitude. So there is no risk for the user and no need to touch the ground. So. Also, there is assisted landing mode. You can press the button. It can go to the ground in a circular way, so it will move down in a spiral and touch the ground. Or you can just press the button also and it could go to the ground in a linear way. So it's very easy, and the user, everybody can use this kind of product. There is no learning, so it's very easy.
I got to say, I love this design. I love the fact that you're going with something different. I guess my only question is, when can I get one? I know pricing hasn't been set yet, and this is a prototype, but when will this start making it out into the public?
It will be on the market by the end of the year, this year.
Now, if they wanted to find out more about Parrot, about the Disco, about any of the drones that you offer, where can they go?
You can go on parrot.com website.
Thank you very much for speaking with us. This is the Parrot Disco, the preferred drone for stranded Martian astronauts everywhere.
My name is Nathan Dick. I represent Nanoleaf. We are a green technology company specializing in LED lighting. So these are our products here. This is actually showcasing our smarter kits. So the smarter kit comes with two bulbs and a hub. So our bulbs are very unique. They're Zigbee controlled, so they'll actually work with any Zigbee hub. But the advantage of our hub is that it works with home kits. So you can call these bulbs by name using Siri on your iPhone, any Apple products, and you can also integrate with any HomeKit products as well. So these bulbs are very energy efficient. We actually designed them to look both beautiful and be functional. The design, it's a folded printed circuit board, so there's a number of reasons we did that. The LEDs sit on the outside so you can have an omnidirectional light pattern, but also the LEDs stay quite cool. So the PCB allows the heat to be dissipated all over the surface. So this allows us to avoid the ugly heat sinks that you see in a lot of different LED light bulbs. So you can get this beautiful looking bulb that stays cool. To connect a bulb, all you do is you press the button, it opens up the network, and then your bulb, as long as it's factory settings, it'll join the hub automatically. So our latest concept product is the Nanoleaf Aurora. The idea is that it's a modular light tile system. The idea is that you'd buy a pack of 10. You can configure it any way you like, on your wall or on your ceiling. So these, they're lights, so they're LED light panels. You can change their color. We've got them coupled with a switch that, depending on which way it sits, the light changes. You can set these as predefined scenes. You can customize them. You can also have stuff like notifications. So maybe the light panel flashes when you get a phone call. It's fully customizable. You can expand the system, add more panels, the system will grow. So if you're looking to learn more about Nanoleaf, you can check us out at nanoleaf.me. Sign up for our mailing list. We'd be happy to keep in touch with you. I'm Nathan Dick, representing Nanoleaf.
Let's talk a little bit about the science of impact. I'm speaking with Matt, the CEO and owner of Impact Gel, who's going to, express his lineage from NASCAR to science. You started in a very violent field, trying to protect drivers from the massive impact of a stock car crash. What exactly did you develop for that?
Well, yeah, it was interesting. Back in, 1998, I still worked for Johnson & Johnson, and we were working on a helmet and seat cooler for NASCAR to cool the seat of a race car. Ended up going into Daytona that year and went 15 times end for end with a driver, Jeff Bodine, sitting on our stuff in his truck, in the truck series. And from there, my life sort of changed. We went on to drop the Cadillac on the wall I designed at Charlotte Motor Speedway. They were already ahead of us a little bit in the science side of it, the University of Nebraska, with a soft wall. So they didn't use my design at that time. But then from there, I invented the Hutchins device, head and neck restraint. Spent a couple of years into that, and Richard Childress was the first partner in Impact Gel, and we didn't really want to look like we were profiting off the death of Dale Earnhardt, and so we sold that company for past, future, present liability, and we formed a company in 2004 around Impact Gel. And the science behind it is it's made out of soy base, made out of soybeans. We take a molecular level of the soybean oil and spin the molecule, and what happens is that suspends the molecule, and also ultimately when ends up finished product, it's a cross link. The linkage or the molecular chain of our molecular structure of the gel never ends, and so what that does is it creates impact that doesn't go through like on a doctor's Scholl's or a plastomer. Energy goes straight through it. With us, energy ripples out within the molecular chain. And so I can show you here quick about, this is the inside of a saddle pad bladder, and we are the number one selling saddle pad in America, but I can take that bladder and put my hand in it and then just hit it hard as I want. The other thing it can do, this is a new formula we just came out with, still out of patent, with the soybean oil, but this is considerably lighter and thinner. This is 1.2 millimeters thick, literally the sheets of a couple sheets of paper. You can take, do the same thing with it, and then you can take an M&M, take a standard M&M and put M&Ms in there, move it over here, hit it, and they won't break, take them over here, and they crumble. So we took that technology and we brought it into a phone case that's super, super thin. And that phone case, now if you can file this with a camera, I'm gonna throw it up in the air over my head and we'll go that high. And it won't break. So if somebody could grab that, I'll show you. What we did is we patented the ability to take a TPU phone case, here's science again, right? So we took TPU, TPE, and then we put our gel, the soy-based gel, into the middle and then laminated them together. So it gets a really clean, crisp, thin, super thin cell phone case that nobody can do anything else with. Last year at CES, Carrot Top took a helicopter, went up 100 feet onto the cement tarmac and dropped our phone case 100 feet without breaking. And so from there, a lot of things have happened. We've been opened up the fields. We started in Walmart as a USA initiative and of a US company to go into all Walmarts. And then from there, we've expanded this year into the carrier stores. So you'll see us in the Verizon and the Sprints of the world. And, you know, you can pick it up there and it'll be super thin and it'll be an amazing thing. So out of science comes a lot of cool things. And, you know, I'm very blessed and very lucky to be standing here today with a technology that's literally can smoke everybody on the market. We also don't burn. You can put a super flame to us for, we just don't catch fire. It goes back out. So the properties are pretty unique and pretty neat.
I got to say, there are always demonstrations at CES of someone hitting something with a hammer, and normally the explanations are slightly pseudoscience, but the fact that you can actually explain to me that these are unbroken chains of molecules, that is solid science, and we've got the proof. We've seen you smash your hand. Now, something you mentioned is it's not solid material. In fact, the harder you hit it, the more force gets distributed.
Very interesting. We can take a pen. And I'll show you on the thicker material, but you can poke a hole through it, and the fact that it's cross-linked seals shut. So it's not a solid, it's not a liquid. The other thing is not affected. You can go into up to 40 below zero, and it'll still say soft. So, you know, the properties are pretty cool. The guy that I went to high school, he's got a chemistry background, and so nothing ever happens by accident.
Matt, I want to thank you for explaining this technology to us. Hopefully we can get some in the studio to play with on know-how. The applications are limitless. I'm already thinking of all the things I'm going to wrap, maybe in flavors of quadcopters. Thank you again for speaking with us. And if they want to find out more about Impact Gel, plug away.
Well, you know, you can go to impactgel.com. Check it out at your local Walmart store. Our cell phones are there. I thought that was my phone ringing. But no, walmart.com, impactgel.com. And check us out, and you can call the office anytime, and we welcome other inventors to come in, come up with ideas. And you know, that's one thing in the science world. You know, we could go on Facebook and try to, what could you invent with Impact Gel? It'd be a neat contest that we could start. And so from the social media standpoint, I think this thing could take off and really, really grab some legs and some traction. The other thing is once again, on the carrier stores, that's a blessing. You know, we'll be in 5,000 Verizon stores coming up here in the spring with a new release of the Galaxy 7. So that's pretty exciting, too. And look for a super, super thin case. It'll be a neat deal.
Again, Matt, thank you so very much for speaking with us. And folks, look for Impact Gel on a future episode of Know How. Until then, good science to you. 2016 is the year that the 3D printer grows up. I'm here at the Robo3D booth speaking with Dan, who's going to explain why their units, their 3D printers, might be your next make or purchase. Dan, love the gear. Explain to me what you think sets Robo3D aside from your competitors.
Well, the fantastic thing about Robo3D is that it is able to provide the biggest print size on the market. So what you see over here is a 10 by 9 by 8 inches build, okay? That's a really good solid build that you've got. At the same time, you've got also the fastest speed on the market at 80 millimeters per second. Also down to 50 microns, which is a really high resolution. But the real interesting thing is the different filaments that we have that are able to democratize the whole of the 3D printing market for the consumer.
I want to get into the filaments in just a bit, but let's talk about the specs, because this is actually important. What we've seen over the last, I'll say 18 months, is there are more and more companies that are offering 3D printers, which means it's getting more difficult to differentiate yourself. And the way that you differentiate yourself is you offer better resolution and you offer faster prints, larger print sizes, which is what attracted us to the Robo3D booth. Now, if someone was looking to start off, give me price points. So looking from this first printer to this one, what are they looking at if they want to start up with a Robo3D?
Well, right now on the market is the Robo R1, which the R1 is at $799. So that's the real workhorse. If you want a fantastic print and with a whole variety of materials, that's the one to get. The entry-level one, which is going to come into the marketplace around about May, June of this coming year, is it around about under the $1,000 market mark, and that is a 5 by 5 by 5 inches build size. The difference here is the electronics and the internal mechanics. So what you have is you have the bed going up and down rather than the nozzles going up and down, making for a much higher resolution and a much stabler build. Over here, you have the prosumer version, and the prosumer version allows you to have two nozzles doing different materials all at the same time. And also at the same time, you can buy an attachment which will allow you to have ceramics. And so if you've broken your grandma's favorite Wedgwood china, you can reconstruct it without her even knowing. Well, I'm kidding. But, you know, that is one of those things, as well as doing food. And so you can have all sorts of icing mixtures, as well as something high in cellulose that will be able to print an amazing feature for your special dinner party.
Dan, let's talk about filaments, because it used to be the debate with filaments was, do I go ABS, do I go PLA, do I do NinjaFlex, what temperature do I want to run my extruder? We've kind of gotten past that. PLA is a great material to work with, it's non-toxic, but we can now get variants of PLA. Tell me about what we've got in front of us.
Well, this particular PLA right now that you have, and if you actually feel it, is wood-infused PLA. You can sand it, you can varnish it, you can actually use it like wood. Okay, so this over here, and compare this to the heaviness of the copper-infused PLA. Copper-infused allows you to polish it, and it reacts the same way. It gives a beautiful green sheen after a period of time. Okay, so those kind of materials are available to you. At the same time, you have a latex type of PLA, which allows you to do tires. Interesting stuff like that. Isn't that fun? Okay, so not only can you build your car, you can also put on the tires at the same time. You also have a iron-infused PLA, which reacts the same way as iron. So if you want your Action Man figure, not only do you have a plastic type of an application, but also you can make real iron parts and gloves and boots and that kind of thing. So democratizing it all in terms of people being able to access different types of prints and also with different materials is probably the most important thing that we can do.
Dan, thank you so very much for talking with us. Now, if they want to find out more about Robo3D and your entire line of printers and filaments, where can they go?
Of course, you can go to Best Buy and purchase your fantastic R1 printer. Soon to bring in the R2, both in terms of mini. But more importantly, if you want really fantastic up-to-date, please come to www.robo3d.com.
Thanks for speaking with us. Robo3D, dream it, build it, make it. Here we are at the end of CES. I'm in my ride, about ready to go home, I thought we should show you off one more bit of tech that impressed me. This is from Casco. These are magnetic mounts that will work on your smart devices, be it your tablet or your phone. Now, the nice thing about this is this is a vent mount. This is a stick mount. This allows you to basically interchange your devices and have an easy-to-use, non-stick, non-destructive way to hold all the tech that's important to you. Now, we've seen tech like this all over CES, and I got to tell you, it's been impressive beyond belief. Once in a while, we get a show like this, a show that takes what we think we want and turns it into what we actually want, from the Internet of Things to really incredible materials to the next generation of travel. This CES has been a bonanza of things like the case mount. Now, don't forget that you can keep watching Twit TV. We're going to bring you the best tech, the best personalities, and pretty much the news from around the tech world, because it's our job and because we love you. Until next time, I'm Father Robert Ballester saying, now that you know how, drive it like you stole it.